because they're easy to make. If you do a mainspring, they're more complicated, more work in them, and it's a bit. And if you make one and it breaks on you, it's a bit of hard luck. Now, I'll show you the there's three types of top lever spring, three particular types. Now, the first type is a, it's got a ball on the end like that, and it has the long arm, a bit longer than that end, and the pin is on the end here, the pin goes in the top, is into the top strap. Then the second type is a type called like that, shed like that, and the both legs are very similar, they're very similar length. And the other one, the other type is this a bit. The other type is the both legs are the same length. You find these in Spanish guns. Now, this one has a pin on this, on the underside of this leg here. That's on the other side. This one has a pin on the end like. Now, this one is called the greener lever spring. This one's called the Scott lever spring, and that one's called the Continental because. This type was found on Belgian, German, Italian, Spanish guns, and these two were mainly on English guns. Now, the reason it's called a greener lever spring, it only fits a greener lever work system. This only fits the Scott lever work system. Well, just remember, three distinct types, and if... As I say, if you were ordering them, you'd have to tell people that you wanted a Scott or a Greener or a Continental. As I say, this is a Continental, it's a Spanish gun, you see. Now, they're easy to make if you stop, but you can order them, you know. I mean, with springs, if you can order them and get the springs and fit them, you know, because they'll come over size, don't bother to make them, because you can make a spring, do all that work, and they get a bit too hard and it'll crack on you. And so you've wasted time, you see. Now, to make a lever spring, you want to get hold of some, this is 332 flat spring steel, which Brownells sell. I'm not plugging Brownells, but I got this from Brownells. It's good spring steel, it works. Now, first of all, let's find a gun I can throw the lever spring out. Okay. Seeing as I've got this one all stripped down, we'll use this one. This has got a Continental. I wouldn't bother normally making one of these Continental ones because I've got a box full of them. But just to show you guys how to make a simple spring, I'll use this one. I'm going to get the spring out first. Something's out of the chat box, isn't it? I've got a situation here where the sear springs getting in the way. Yeah, get him out. Okay, there's the spring. It's pretty simple. So get a strip of this stuff, and first of all, polish what's going to be the inside part of the spring. Just. Okay, I've been cleaned up there. Put a mark where you're going to bend it on the outside. Now the next move is to next move, we get the spring hot. Come on. It's hot enough with the lights. Squeeze it up. Straighten it up. And get it hot again. That's just about flattened it. Right, now what I do, finally, before I do any more, make sure it's got enough length. Yes, I've got enough. Just about enough there. Okay, I'll bring it, warm it up once more because that works.